Sounds good.
Hello everyone, welcome to a brand new game, and by brand new I mean a game that's over like 20 years old, and by 20 I mean like 30. I'm going to be playing the Mega Man Legacy Collection, starting with Mega Man 1, and I have a guest with me today, and I have one of the guests with me today. It's Bully. By the way, I also got myself a new seating arrangement since, unfortunately, I noticed the Goro save was about to barge in and I had to book it. So I had to give the world government back the empty throne. I might be able to sneak in another. I'll probably be able to sneak in another time when I get the DLC for One Piece Odyssey. But that won't be for a while. It'll probably be if the DLC goes on sale. I did do a few things on One Piece Odyssey while I was there. I did some side quest stuff, and I'm still currently trying to find all the stuff for Nico Robin. But I was able to complete the challenge runs. The bosses, it basically consists of you fighting powered up versions of bosses, and that's basically your means to level up your characters to as high as you can. But enough about that. It's time for some Mega Man. I'm playing the Mega Man Legacy Collection for PS4 with Mega Man's 1 through 6. They did release a Legacy Collection 2 with Mega Man's 7 to 10. And I of course have Mega Man 11 physical for the PS4. So, depending on the timing, I might be able to get to that. Mega Man, Dr. Wily has stolen my robots and caused them to go evil. Go destroy them. So, of course, being the first Mega Man game, it was released on the NES and and regular Famicom console.
Sorry, I'm taking it.
That's okay.
Dan made him always late.
Yeah. Testing. I'm a little low on stream.
Oh, let me see that. Let me check that real quick. How about now?
Testing 1, 2, testing.
He sounds better.
And I do have the mainstream going on Discord as well. So I do have
I
the main.
I would watch it, but I'm too much of a hipster to watch the mainstream.
Yeah. The reason why I'm doing this is because I'm taking the opportunity to test whether or not being able to show it on there would work at the same time as streaming itself. So I'd be able to do the same thing when we do a Let's Dub of Okami. So that's why the stream is like low quality 15 frames, because the purpose is that so that you can see the text.
I see.
So let's go here.
It's not just laziness. There is an excuse.
So right now we're playing Mega Man 1, Cutman, Gutsman, Da-da! Iceman, Bombman, and Fireman.
Wait a second. Fireman's not a mech droid. He's just a profession.
So now we're gonna fight Kung Fu Cutman!
As opposed to the regular Cutman. I say that joke fully aware that there is a regular Cutman.
Yeah, I believe he's in this game.
Man, imagine being Cutman right alongside Kung Fu Cutman. Like, just imagine if we had Aiden on the stream, and then right next to him was Ninjutsu Aiden. What a way to destroy a man's ego.
No, you can't destroy my ego, Sword Gun.
Mega Man 1 actually has a, has a scoring system on it.
Remember back in the day when we had high scores?
Now everything just feels like a low score.
Yeah.
I'm hoping I can get some,
Yeah, most of us are.
Get some HP back.
It's been real hard since my credit card declined.
That's kind of what happens when you try to... when you keep betting everything on frickin' mortgage lender.
Mortgage lifter.
There we go, finally. Not very much help, sadly. No, I can't reach that. Dang it. I had a massive health increase and I couldn't get it. That sucks. I'll take that one. That means I don't have to risk getting that bottom one. Yeah, me taking that hit from that frickin' big eye sucked. Boom. Kung Fu Cutman's been cut down.
So what was your first Mega Man game?
Dude, you can't just ask a man about his first.
I can't.
Yep. My first Mega Man game was actually... Ah! I was trying to adjust the audio for you guys. My first Mega Man game was actually Mega Man X. Because the Super Nintendo was the first game, first console that I ever had the opportunity to play. I distinctly remember two games from my childhood was Mega Man X and Lawnmower Man.
Lawnmower Man.
Dude, you actually had Lawnmower Man, that's so great.
Now I'm trying to remember. Trying to remember. I'll just go after Gutsman next. Da-da! Anybody know about the Gutsman meme?
No.
Okay, so there was an episode of the Ruby Spears Mega Man cartoon that, where they went to a... where Mega Man, Roll, and Dr. Light all went to an amusement park. And there was... There was a kangaroo mascot. And... that kangaroo mascot... Ah, fudge. I slipped. That kangaroo mascot... Rush chose to freaking... just like rip off, notice something was up, so he bit off the dude's the kangaroo mascot's tail, and he revealed freaking like it was gut was like all he saw was like Gutsman's ass. And then it had the sound on it.
See, the only thing I know about Gutsman is that he has a sword, though it's not quite accurate to call it a sword. It's more of a slab of metal.
Wrong
Gus.
Wrong
Gus.
Oh, from, Berserk. Yeah, I get it.
I heard they're doing another, attempt at, a Berserk anime.
Well, hopefully it goes better than the last attempt.
Yeah, hopefully. Because Berserk really deserves to have a better, anime adaptation. It really does.
Yeah. Because the recent Berserk adaptation had like the worst CG graphics I've ever seen.
It did. It wasn't even funny how bad it was. It was just bad.
To be fair, things being so bad that it's go up on funny just sad is kind of fitting for Berserk.
Unfortunately, you are correct.
Let's see if Cutman's, Gutsman's weakness. It's been a long time since I played this, so I don't remember weaknesses very well.
I'm pretty sure Gutsman is very weak to emotional damage.
No, it's not. He only took, like, one hit. So, one pixel, so I have to beat him with the Mega Buster.
I'm
boss doesn't seem particularly difficult.
Yeah, I realized I can hit him. I realized I could just hit him as he jumped.
I realized all I needed to do was to kill him, and then suddenly that worked.
We beat him with the power of friendship and this gun.
And this gun I found.
Inside my arm. What is that about?
Do you think Mega Man's ever like, whoa, be careful, I'm armed?
Yeah, I'm pretty sure they made that joke in the Ruby Spears cartoon. I keep hitting the R1.
Maybe you should stop doing that.
Yeah, because my thing is, like, I keep hitting the R1 button thinking that I could do a quick swap of Mega Man's weapons, because they had that option in the Mega Man Anniversary Collection. Actually, let's actually check real quick. Button configuration. Oh, okay. R1 is Mega Man 1 pause and select to just pause the game. Okay.
Gotcha.
Ah, I have to pay attention to the electrical arc so I don't get hit. It's time for one of Mega Man's favorite things. It's the disappearing, reappearing blocks.
Yay, a childhood favorite. Many a boy and girl would just cheer the praises of the disappearing and reappearing blocks. You know, there's a whole holiday dedicated to it in Germany.
Oh yeah?
Yeah, disappear a Tugendogen.
I'm almost certain that you're full of crap, but...
You see, it's a time when all the unruly children suffer from having the roofs disappear above their heads as their parents throw them out into the snow. But if they manage to improve their attitudes before they freeze to death, then their roofs reappear as they're welcomed back into someone's home. Not always their parents, mind you, but someone.
Someone. Anyone.
That's just... Fuck. But honestly, though, there are a lot of people who are, like, not... Ow. Are really not fans of... the yoga blocks, as they're called.
I wonder why.
Oh, come on! The power-up just fell into the... The power-up just fell through the stairs. Oh, and by the way, there is a thing in guarding this game that's different than all the others. Is that Mega Man in this game has momentum.
Ooh, gross.
Like, because it was... If I recall correctly, the movement and the animations and stuff like that is based more based a little bit on Mario.
Oh.
Now to use Guts Man. so I can get this. It's called the Magnet Beam. And it's not like Magnet Man Magnet Beam. It basically creates a bridge. I'll take that health.
Or the health will take you.
Health taking you. That actually sounds a little bit like a poison mushroom from Mario. What you think is health will... What you think is health will actually kill you!
Ooh.
Imagine how funny that would be in, like, the Mario and Luigi games. Just go to grab that health power-up, pop that item, and all of a sudden you just die.
Okay,
right,
thanks for falling off.
Right at the end of the Mario movie, Mario grabbed one more mushroom for good luck against the final fight with Bowser, and he just kills over and dies in the end credits roll.
If there's a post-credit scene where Bowser's sitting there tapping his watch, you know, it's been a while, he should be showing up soon, right? Like, goes and steps outside the room. Oh, get that!
I am 100% unlikely to survive this fight.
Not with that attitude.
Actually, I think that attitude is exactly what's making him unlikely to survive.
Yeah, I don't think that's, I don't think that, Gutsman is his weakness either, so... I think I'll go to stage select and choose someone else for right now. There's Iceman, Bombman, and Fireman. Let's go with Bombman. I remember a ton of the Ruby Spear cartoons because I watched them repeatedly, regardless of how terrible, regardless of how, like, not good they are, they were still enjoyable to watch.
The only thing I remember from the, Ruby Spear cartoon, the episode where everyone gets turned into a were-lion.
Of course freaking, you would.
Freaking Curse of the Lion Men.
Yeah.
Cursed is right. animation quality for that episode is the worst.
It is.
All the budget for that season went towards freaking the final episode and Mega X, and that's it. Because they actually did do a, they did do a, like a promotional thing for Mega Man X. But the problem is, though, in my opinion, they completely messed up freaking Mega Man X's character doing that. I'm gonna die. Damn it.
Oof.
I just saw the freaking not Bullet Bill.
The Bullet Steven. Projectile William.
Yeah, Projectile William.
And don't just hate it when you get hit by a projectile William from off screen.
Yeah.
I'm gonna go ahead and get this free health that's there since I took damage. Thank you. By the way, there is something you do that you need to be aware about in this game. Because one of the big things when it comes to Mega Man is, like, you have invincibility. Like, you have invincibility frames when you get hit. And one of the things that happens is if you have invincibility frames when you land on spikes, you won't like instantly die. You have a chance.
Even though the spikes normally insta-kill you.
Yes. In Mega Man 1, that does not happen. If even if you have invincibility frames, you will die if you land in spikes.
The game just says screw your invincibility.
Yeah, this is the first Mega Man game, so there are some things that they decided to change to make it better later. Time for Bomb Man.
So strange that they changed his name from Arabian Man in the English translation.
sorry, that's actually Flame Man in Mega Man X in Mega Man 6.
Yes, Ifrit Man.
Because Flame Man in Mega Man 6 actually does have like the like wrap on head like Apu has.
Oh goodness.
Because it was supposed to be an international robot tournament that took place there. But all the robots got taken over by Mr. X.
It is definitely not a reused villain. Definitely a totally new guy.
Okay, so I have Bomb Man, so screw it, let's go with Fireman next. I'm not even bothering with frickin'.
Yeah, most people aren't these days.
I'm not bothering, because ain't nobody got time for that.
And the immortal word.
Of what's her face? Because that meme was so long ago and I don't remember her name. I have to take that hit, otherwise I get knocked into the pit. I should have gone with Iceman next, because if you have Iceman, you can actually freeze those fire pillars. I'll just take all this health. Thanks for the apology, game. Nah. I was doomed either way. I believe that's where the checkpoint was. Getting yourself a drink there?
Oh, can you hear me?
Yeah, I heard you take those gulps.
That wasn't a drink, that was a drink.
By the way, this is the...
What the fuck you want?
By the way, this is the main reason why it's good to have frickin' Ice Slasher. But I have an alternative. I have magnet beam, so... Yay, thank you, health! Well, to be fair, considering how hot this level is, it makes sense to freaking drink up as much water as possible. Yeah. Yay! I'll take that extra life.
Some of that cool, crisp,
hydrating water. That doesn't sound good.
What does?
The sound zero eating it.
He's trying his best. Really, that's all we can do.
It's unfortunate that's not enough.
Unfortunately, your best just happens to be worse than everyone else's average. I need to get back into Prequel Adventure. That was a good webcomic.
You read a lot of your webcomics.
And isn't actually that weird compared to what I've seen you read, motherfucker?
Don't worry about what I read.
Took you to Texas Furry Fiesta. Someone who claims not to be a furry, and yet you recognize more weird furry shit than I do.
In my defense, I did not inhale.
In your defense, my ass.
In your defense, my butt, nothing will penetrate it. Freaking, I still remember those old YouTube boobs.
I don't recognize that one. What have you been watching, my friend?
It's called, I'm trying to remember, I think it's like, it's not Snively Needs Six Cotter Pins to Enchant His Belt, it's another one from Kurobo Productions from a long time ago. I do need to refine that. But freaking the Snively Needs Six Cotter Pins to Enchant His Belt is really good too. It's like, I'll take that health.
What's the name of my favorite one? Deliver Us. That one is fantastic. SpongeBob Deliver Us.
Whoops, wrong button. There you go.
Well, Voli, which one's that one?
It is a pretty whack one. I'll have to send it to you later, but it is an edit of the pizza delivery episode of SpongeBob, and it's fucking wacky because it, like, actually has a bit of a storyline to it and is full of deep esoteric symbolism. It's...
Okay, I see it.
It's weird.
At the time I jumped... Thank you. There we go. The one thing that you need for... The one thing that you need for dealing with Yogu blocks is patience. But the problem is, though, a ton of people that I know have really no desire to like pay attention and look at the pattern and all that, because a lot of them would just take the opportunity to just use Magnet Beam to jump over all of it.
Understandable, honestly.
Yeah.
Yeah, but if you happen to not have Magnet Beam, you get... Yeah, if you happen to not have... Dang it. This is what happens when you run out of patience, ladies and gentlemen.
Mister, my friends have no patience. I'm so much better than them.
Immediately uses Magnet Beam afterwards because he ran out of patience. That's me.
You see, what you gotta do to succeed here is not be me.
What do you have to do to succeed? It's just... not be zero right now.
There we go. Darn, I was hoping for some health. Health, please. Health, please, you penguins. Thank you. More health, please. Thank you. Thank you. You know what's really lovely? Ice physics. Penguins. Okay, yeah, you're just not spawning anymore? Okay, fine. Fire versus ice, who will win? Let's see. Ice wins. Because Yeah. Today's not my day. Let's just deal with Elecman, because I know I have his weakness.
Improper grounding?
Gee, if only I had Groundman right now. But Groundman's not until Mega Man in base. I need to switch back to the Mega Buster. Oh, by the way, if you do change weapons, you do have... You will lose grip of the... You will lose grip of the...
Go on, you got it.
Lose grip of the ladder.
Okay.
Okay, there he goes.
I'm gonna start guessing words for you, and you weren't gonna like what I have to say.
Don't tempt Voli. He really will go that far.
By the way, I'm trying to remember if the song here sounds familiar.
That's probably because it's from Mega Man.
No, this used, like, another... Like an actual song, you know?
Are you saying that the ones from Mega Man aren't real? Are you saying that their musical talent is not up to your snuff?
Fuck off.
Are you saying Mega Man is not a real genre of music?
Yeah, you're right,
Mega
it's not...
Man is a subpar video game, so its music doesn't count.
You just fuck off. I'll take that health, though. And then immediately after that, take a hit, because... Fuck off. And by the way, even though it does show the magnet beam there, there's no point in getting it again, because I have it right here already.
Now you're staring at me, Bubbles. What is it? We're not doing Smash Mania right now. You'll have your chance later.
That's next Sunday.
Yeah.
Was the kitty winning at Smash Mania?
Made it all the way
to the finals.
Then Bubbles lost to Fingers.
Yep.
Was she Incineroar?
No, she was Falco. With black feathers. Because I forgot Incineroar was in that game.
You could have made her a cat, but you made her a bird instead.
Next time she'll be a cat.
Oh, cool. UNCC would be able... Game Cobra would have a fun time together. Game Cobra be a salad cat. And because of that, the...
What's a salad cat?
Green cat.
Oh, I know what you're talking about now. The Meowscarig.
If you bite me, little man, I'll break you.
I'll eat your ass.
I think I figured out how to freaking deal with him. Just that still fighting him is a pain in the rear, so now I have to go through the entire stage again. And I have no desire to use the freaking rewind feature of this game because that's cheating.
And remember, kids, cheating is not cool.
Remember, kids, cheating is half the battle. What?
Cheating is worth half a leg and a mead.
Remember, kids, cheating. If you don't cheat, you don't want to win hard enough.
Just ask Bill Belichick.
Remember, children, if you ain't cheating, you ain't eating. I'm sure this is a fantastic message for the kids that will not cause any lasting problems.
Yay, I got the health before it disappeared. Yeah, maybe the little frickin' flea robot fell off because there was a time I ran into before when I was just about to make it up to the top of that ladder, and then that robot just clips me right on the corner and causes me to fall a screen. I did just notice something funny. Hold on a second.
Oh, definitely wasn't something one of us said.
Yep.
In that case, could not be anything we've talked about recently.
Okay, never mind. I guess it's a combination of taking damage and falling at the same time, because during the fight with that robot there, the flame portion of the... the shield portion of the fire weapon lasted a lot longer than it's supposed to. I was about to say, like, if that's the case, then there's a way to cheese it to have just the flame shield portion of it continue forever.
Forever and ever.
You would think that having a legacy collection game like this, they would prevent that kind of thing.
You'd think, but regrettably, we don't live in a world where video game design is widely respected, even by its own industry.
I have one life left. I'll just die right there and then just friggin' battle like man with full health. I don't stand a chance otherwise. Dang it. I was trying to get the friggin'... I was trying to get the frickin' high ground so that I could frickin' drop bombs on him.
But it was too late, he already had the high ground.
Screw it, I'm going back to Iceman. Because me getting more frustrated at this is not going to help. Oh, come on! I jumped on that! The recurring curse is real. The streaming curse is real.
It truly be like that, man.
Forgive me, I needed to vent for a minute.
You needed to be sus? I'm sorry, that was a terrible joke.
I'm going back to Elecman. At least I know I have Elecman's weakness. It's just a matter of getting there with enough lives. Oh, I just realized I just... this entire time. I just realized an hour in that I forgot to put up the frickin' thing for... forgot to change my thing.
What thing?
The thing that says what I'm streaming.
I just realized I've been muted for a while.
Why were you muted?
I got a call. Instead of having the electricity alternate between the different beams, if Dr. Wily just had one constant one, he wouldn't have these problems.
Yeah?
Yeah, but then we run into the situation of Spiked Wall Man. Freaking Dr. Wily fails at life. It's like, I would have created this before I made Spring Man.
Uh, I love really the one would... where he gets to the room and it's just the one little helmet dude. He's just been ordered to stay there and not pop up.
Yeah, freaking Elecman is the hardest boss in the game.
Elecman was the first one to realize that he could do contact damage against you. He was just like, oh shit, I can just ride his ass and kill him that way.
Like, oh shit, I can just not suck at this. Imagine.
Excuse me a second, I need to use the bathroom.
Alright.
Asha, what do we do to keep everyone entertained in the meantime?
I don't know.
The pressure,
we need to tell hilarious anecdotes that are slightly racially charged.
Let me see. What would a professional streamer do in this situation? Hey, Dan, did you hear about this one episode of Family Guy?
Family Guy.
A family picture.
A Family Guy.
Ah, good old Game Grumps.
Yeah.
They fell off really, really hard.
Which is very, very unfortunate.
I remember watching this one guy, he's kind of a small-time streamer, and he was reminiscing about how, like, the day he passed the Game Grumps in views. It's like, these are these guys that I used to look up to, and now they make trash content, and now I'm bigger than them, and it's just a weird experience.
Yeah, it kinda is.
I have to imagine it feels very odd. So Mega Man's a fun game.
Yeah.
I had never played it before, so it's kind of interesting watching Zero stream it.
Yeah, the only ones I've played were the RPGs on the Game Boy and the remake of the first game, this game, on the PSP.
I see. So you sinned.
Yes. Exclusively.
I would expect nothing more.
But it's a pretty decent series. Oh, do you remember fucking Mighty Number 9?
No, I remember Mighty Number 9, but I never fucked him.
You know what I meant.
I did not have sexual relations with that video game.
Yeah, I'm back.
Hey, we were just talking about Mighty Number 9.
You know, that all-time classic.
Totes my goats, especially that... Especially not Proto Man.
But, yeah, Mighty Number 9 is just kind of the telltale case of, never get too hyped for a game when its only real, selling point is it's made by someone who is a big name on the original development team for a game that has a lot of nostalgic value behind it.
Yeah, I remember warning a bunch of people about Outer Worlds, and no one listened to me on that one.
Dude, Outer Worlds was just such a disappointing game.
Everyone was hoping that it would be like, it would be like Obsidian's way of showing Bethesda, this is how you make an RPG. But instead, it was more like Obsidian was like, oh, that's how you make an RPG, while leaning over Bethesda's shoulder.
Yeah.
In that kind of situation, no one wins. We all just lose.
I actually heard more positive reception when it came to the Outer Worlds, honestly.
I don't know where you heard that.
Yeah, I don't know either, dude, because all I ever heard of Outer Worlds was,
like, not terrible, not stinky poo-poo, but definitely, wow, this is not good.
Yeah.
Always just a kind of a, man, I wish this was actually a good game.
Yeah. Like, I really wish Obsidian had not been so totally corrupted by, I can't think.
Bethesda is not any better, especially considering freaking Fallout 76.
Yeah. Not better, but at the same time, not much worse. But then again, Fallout 76.
Trying to remember if there's anything else I hadn't tried yet. Let's try cut, man. At least we know that's his weakness now. Now I just have to survive.
I know that'll be difficult for you.
Might present some issues.
Yeah.
There we go, finally.
Oh, it's about time.
Yeah, I knew you weren't a failure.
I definitely had confidence in you.
I definitely wasn't betting against you at every possible turn.
I absolutely did not lose a lot of money on that deal.
Yeah.
Well, you lose a lot of money on every deal you seem to run into, so that's not that big of a loss to me.
Yeah.
By the way, if there's one game that I'm always reminded of when I see these frickin' penguins, is frickin' Mega Man Network Transmission.
Yeah?
Because a 3D version of those penguins shows up in that game. In that game's version of Iceman stage. Because Mega Man Network Transmission is the, like Mega Man Bell Network, 1.5. There we go. Wasn't paying attention. I'm trying to take this opportunity to calm down.
My man's a bit tilted.
Man's a little faulty.
It's Salt really Man! Da-da! Okay, I got distracted for a second. I thought I was dropping frames. But no, the indicator says I'm not dropping any frames.
Well, the indicator would never be wrong, right?
The indicator would never lie, would it?
I keep forgetting where the where that block is going to appear. If I'm gonna calm down, I'm better off calming down up here. Instead of calming down down there. You know what? No. Work with me, please.
Us or the game?
The game.
A little both.
This pattern is delicious. It's totally not fucking impossible for me to make it across.
These patterns are delicious. Impossible is my favorite.
There, I'll take the extra life and move on. And the health. And the energy. There, let's move on.
For a half second, I thought that was the boss.
Dr. Wily's just trolling us at this point.
Yeah, it's like, you know, fuck you. You don't get a special boss, because you keep destroying them. Here.
Fuck you, Doc. That blue. Blue. Fiend.
Fuck you, Mega Man!
Frickin'. Anyone remember frickin' Dr. Wily's frickin'. That frickin' villain accent they gave him for like. Show like, ah, he's the villain. There. I can move on! Move on to the Wily Castle. We must not defeat Dr. Wily.
Dr. Wily.
Dr. Wow.
I go with him, man. I heard that. I keep hearing things like for the explanation as to why he sounds like that. It's either that he was just like some intern that they brought in to voice Dr. Light, or he was drunk. Maybe a little bit of both. I don't know.
I'd believe it.
Yeah, happily the ice slasher beam actually freezes enemies in place, which makes the big eyes less of an issue.
What about the small eyes?
Well, the small eyes are still very much so an issue.
Yes,
there's nothing we can do about that.
Yeah, they just tend to get in the way.
Science can only go so far.
Yep.
I fucked up.
Thus we ask the age-old question, has science gone too far?
That's a question asked by anti-robot enthusiasts everywhere. Also known as those, also known as the mini-villains from frickin' the Mega Man Archie comics.
I don't know.
Yeah, I don't know either, man.
Anti-AI enthusiasts kind of have a point. AI is kind of scary.
Okay, but what if the AI is sexy?
We must create the best version of Cortana. Oh, wait. We already have Cortana. Shit!
We have the shit version of Cortana.
We have the barest basic bones of Cortana.
We have Cortana at home.
Yeah, we really do just have Cortana at home, don't we?
Everyone has Cortana at home if you have Windows.
Yeah, and I have like three of those.
Dang it! I was afraid of jumping. I was afraid of jumping and hitting the. Yeah, I was afraid of hitting the top ceiling, but I also had forgotten how completely fast Mega Man dips when he frickin' falls. And there's what I was talking about. And there's what I was talking about with the, if you take damage and you fall into spikes, you die regardless.
I mean, they are spikes. What were you expecting, man?
Yeah. They're kind of there for one reason.
Part of me wishes that I was playing this on the Mega Man Anniversary Collection version of this. Because the Mega Man Anniversary Collection version of this Mega Man uses the PlayStation version of Mega Man, which they did a bunch of quality of life changes to it. Like, for example, the R and L buttons actually changes your weapons. And they updated the visual indicator so that they show you like a picture with a weapon on it.
I guess it's true what they say, PlayStation does with Nintendo.
Then it's supposed to be Sega! Sega does what Nintendo don't.
Sega. What about my Sega?
What about my Sega?
What about my personal Sega? I want to believe that Zero has no idea why we just did that.
I legitimately have no idea why you just did that. It just sounds funny to me. this is the area where you have to have Magnet Beam in order to advance. If you do not have Magnet Beam, it's impossible for you to complete this, and you have to go back to Elecman stage.
Lovely.
Ladies and gentlemen, are you ready to enter hell?
Always and forever.
Because here's the devil! The Yellow Devil, ladies and gentlemen.
The most terrifying enemy.
He is. He is one of the most infamous bosses in gaming.
Gotta love how one of his attacks is just entering the stage.
All man has to do is just show up.
His plan, I show up, I win.
Okay, so, I pull up. And that's it.
I really don't need anything beyond that, that's the whole plan.
There is a way to glitch to win against this boss, though. But I am not going to do that.
What?
Yeah.
Because I figured out the... That's the glitch to win method. If I continue to hit R1 repeatedly, each attack, this bypasses his invincibility frames and would destroy him easily.
Do you understand? That then allows that attack to hit him every single frame it's on his body.
Pretty much, yeah.
I remember I did a glitch like that in 2016 to kill L because it was funny.
Dang it! But you see my apprehension of using that.
Yeah. To an extent.
Play lame, win game.
Ah. I'd much rather use the... Because another way to destroy those blocks is to use the elect beam. To break them. But that's also using, elect man's, the yellow devil's weakness. So, that's not a good idea. I hesitated. I frickin' hesitated there.
Yeah, maybe don't do that.
Shit has been.
Dang it. I'm fucked. And if I recall correctly, even if I died, this energy won't reset, so this is an automatic game over.
Lovely.
And this would actually waste a ton of time, so... Fuck you, game.
So, fuck you.
Bitch.
Going out on my own terms.
I decide when I die.
It's either I do this now and just restart the room, or I die two times on purpose. And come back here later.
Why do you want to die on purpose?
Because I'd have to die on purpose in order to get a game over to recharge all of my energy. Because under the current circumstance, it's impossible for me to grind energy in order to recharge the magnet beam. So I would literally have to die a game over in order to recharge the energy properly.
So he says anyway.
I fucking did it again. This is the only time that I would actually fucking do this. Because this is an actual fucking game-breaking shit.
You can tell he's getting heated because he's finally cursing.
Yeah.
There, let's move the fuck on. I would never do this in any other game except this one. Because otherwise I'd be wasting time freaking... I'd be wasting time reloading freaking... dealing with game overs and shit. And even then, even with all that... And even then, I'll likely die against freaking Yellow Devil again anyway.
Man is really tilted.
Told you, man, the powers are getting to him.
And yeah, but that's another problem, though. I don't know if you can tell on the screen, but Yellow Devil actually fires a shot at me that's extremely fast and near impossible to avoid. That's how come I take damage every time I fight him.
I see, so he's bullshit.
Another reason why a lot of people just use the pause glitch and get it over with.
Just rip that band-aid off early.
Yeah.
Hello.
Hello.
Hello. Oh.
Hey, guys.
How you doing?
Doing good. Let me just... Where are... There you are. I was wondering where your character might pop up. I hope you all enjoy me torturing myself.
Seems fun.
Oh, you bet. It's a Mega Man's 4, right?
This is Mega Man 1.
Oh yeah, that's a good one. Have you done Elec Man yet? Because that one always makes me want to pull my hair out.
I did Elec Man. I'm dealing with the Yellow Devil right now.
Yeah, you managed to make it through the cock and ball torture. That is Elec Man.
You know, when I played Mega Man 1, this is as far as I made it right here. I can never make it past right here.
The Yellow Devil is such a jerk.
Way easier in Power Up, though. I've noticed.
Yeah, they definitely made him a lot more fair.
Yeah, especially when it comes to those upgraded type of games. Where they made it 2.5D. They gave those guys more of a tell when they do things.
Yeah, like a lead-in animation kind of. Like you could see when he exchanges the, you know, chunks of himself, you can kind of see which one's about to be queued up.
Yeah.
Just a little.
Dang it. I have to wait for it to go down, because it's blocking the path now.
Damn it.
There we go.
It's always tough when you have to wait for it to go down before you can keep going.
So the problems of the having furry biology.
Fun story about the Yellow Devil. I did not know when I was younger about the pause glitch. You can totally cheese him. And so my brother, for years, just totally gaslit me that he could just, like, own this game effortlessly. Because he just cheated the hell out of it.
Wow. That's funny.
Yeah, I already showed Vully and Aiden the pause glitch, but I have no intention of doing that because I don't want to cheat. The only time that I will basically cheat is, is the magnet bridge section. This is the area where you have to use the area where you have to have the magnet beam. Because if you run out of magnet beam before completing that area, then you have to basically do a game over. You have to game over in order to
Game over yourself
in order to recharge the magnet beam in any efficient amount of time.
Game over, yeah.
I think they decided when they were doing Mega Man Legacy Collection, they're like, hey guys, if we're going to include Mega Man 1, we need to make sure we put in the rewind feature, because a lot of people own guns nowadays, and this is going to end poorly.
Yeah.
We're going to have a lot of TVs get shot.
Honestly, I would prefer that they have both the rewind and the upgrades that they did for the Mega Man Anniversary Collection. Like, for example, R1 and L1 can flip between weapons quickly.
That was a nice update. I do like the music though. Like, Mega Man 1, it definitely is not as solid as some of the others, but I still kind of enjoy the music. Like, I love the Yellow Devil's actual boss theme.
Mega Man 2 has the best music in the entire franchise, fight me.
Mega Man 4, bitch! Mega Man 4!
Alright, I'll fight you. Not because I have any stake in this argument, but because I just want to fight you.
Yeah. Aiden's just looking for an excuse.
Aiden's always looking for a reason.
Like, oh, come on, don't you like... It's like, don't you think, like, the awesome, like, riff on Final Countdown for Infinity Maginian Stage in X6 totally makes it the best?
Mega Man 6 was designed by sadists, Mega Man designers.
X6. Mega Man X6.
Yeah. X6 was designed... That's what I mean. X6 was designed by sadists of the highest order.
And I'm a complete masochist because I 100%ed that game.
How did your balls feel after that?
I don't think my man's balls fell.
He's like searching for the words, but it's just like nom flashbacks in his head. He's just seeing the napalm going off and just thinking back to it.
He's just remembering Mega Man with the paddle.
I just love in Mega Man X6 how like they weren't even expecting to make another X, so like they bringing Zero back, they like couldn't even think of a reason why. He's just like, oh yeah, I hit myself after I died to repair myself. I got better. It's fine.
No, you have to say it right. It's I hit myself to repair myself. Whoops, wrong one.
And I still the level with the evil death donut, the mini boss that just keeps coming back. They make you fight the same mini boss like 6 times. I can't.
Yeah, that's the worst. Like every stage has an awesome argument for why it is the worst stage in Mega Man. The worst stage in that game.
Oh, you wasted a lot of energy there.
Yeah, but happily that's the last time I need to use Magnet Beam for that stage. Because the checkpoint is right here, because up next is the Yellow Devil.
You see this one, Brett? This guy is a jerk. I don't know if you've played this game at all, Brett. Like, to this point.
I have actually never made it to Yellow Devil before.
This guy is
such
a
jerk. But I am aware of the horror that this boss is.
Yeah, there's some interesting stuff about him on his Wikipedia page. Let me see here. It's quite something. Let me see here. According to Wikipedia, the free encyclopedia, cock and ball torture is a BDSM or sexual.
I'm thinking, oh, I might learn something today.
Damn it! You made me laugh and I died.
Yeah, that's what Voli does.
It's like, pause, I can't handle this.
I'm very sorry to do this to you all, but you all keep talking.
I got limits.
Sorry, I just realized Defen cuts off all of you all on stream, so I'm gonna have to do this. So I'm gonna have to take off my headphones instead.
Oh boy.
I'm only making the host rage quit.
It's my talent.
This really is like one of Voli's big talents.
Yeah, it's a weird ass cutie mark, but I got it.
That's okay, I ended an argument on the unofficial House Pets fan server the other day. They were arguing whether Fox or Vino were more likable, which answer's obvious, but there are a disturbing amount of Vino fans over there.
How unfortunate.
If you don't know, Vino is intentionally the most annoying character in House Pets, like, by far.
He's all the main characters are in a place called the No Binos Club.
Yeah.
But that argument was going on for like 2 hours, like I just popped in there and I said something to the effect of, look, Bino's okay if you're into hate fucking, and like instantly everyone just noped out in one like swift motion. Like no one wanted to actually like grapple with that one.
Wow.
Which, I mean, it's true.
I speak no lies. The Yellow Devil is the other reason Yellow Devil in the first game is so much worse is because you don't have any E-Tank. Like, at least in Mega Man 3, they'll give you E-Tanks.
Yeah.
I don't know, I think the character might just be pretty hard to deal with on its own.
Yeah. There's also that. If you know, wanna pussy out.
You wanna be a bitch. You don't wanna be a bitch, do you?
Who here wants to be a little bitch?
I wanna win.
Oh man.
So fun fact, the Yellow Devil was in Mega Man 1, actually the first 3 games were actually so poorly translated that the instruction manual had to like make up a ton of stuff about the games.
Yeah.
And the Yellow Devil was in the West until like the late 90s, officially just the Rock Monster.
Rock Monster?
Just the Rock Monster. I guess they thought he was made of rocks.
Yeah.
Good old rock and ball torture.
Oh god.
Voli, do you need to talk to someone?
A therapist, probably.
Yeah?
Yeah, probably.
Therapist especially like, if... Look, I charge a lot, but there's some things we don't do.
especially if they're recommended by Sean Connery.
Tr-
So, tell me more about this fucking ball fixation you have.
Rolly has a lot of fixations, which I don't understand, and I think my poor friend needs help.
You need, like, an intervention, but you need to do it in a way that, like, doesn't just escalate with him being, like, harder daddy and everyone noping out.
Yeah.
So my mom's actually a therapist, and, she does something I can't wrap my head around. She does, largely grief counseling. And there's just, you could not pay me to try and, like, wrap my head around how hard that is for people.
What kind of counseling?
Grief.
Grief, yeah, no.
She worked at the hospital for a really long time, helping people who, relatives and patients that had, like, cancer and stuff. And it's just, it's really heavy. I have no idea how she does it. Like, I would rather spend my days talking about why people would go for cock and ball sports.
Yeah.
Freaking. Happy, I got my health back there.
A little sleepy.
Yeah. You know what that remind me of? Freaking Fleeman from Castlevania.
Yeah, I can see that.
Fleeman from Castlevania, the freaking bullet bills here are Medusa heads.
Do you guys remember what angry video game nerd episode it was when he told the story about his childhood encounter with the Yellow Devil or whatever?
Oh, I don't know. I know which one you mean, but I couldn't tell you which one it was.
I don't know which one that is.
No, he has the right to be angry about that one. Like, I know he plays it up a lot of times for the sake of the jokes, but, like, seriously, some games earn it. Like, the Medusa head thing is, like, knocking you into the pit is the worst. And it was actually a bug in Mega Man 1 that they fixed in later games where you die instantly when you hit the spikes. In later games, you actually do get the iframes.
I was about to say, like, I didn't know if that was a bug. I didn't really know if that was a bug or not. That means they really should have freaking fixed. They really should have fixed in later versions.
Is that one of those ones where the community has an argument as to whether it's a bug or a feature?
Yeah,
it took until they data mined it and people found that it was a bug in a couple of objects in the game. It was more of a bug in, like, how iframes were implemented, and it's the same reason you can do the invincibility and pause glitch.
Okay.
It's actually the same core problem.
Wait, can you pause glitch yourself and remove your own iframes?
It takes really careful timing, but you can pause glitch yourself into and out of damage in weird ways.
Interesting.
You got this, Zero.
You don't got the Zero, you really don't. Pressure.
It's gonna be okay,
Zero. Well, it's nice that you had the angel and the devil join your stream simultaneously on your shoulder.
Wait, so we've seen the yellow devil, so where's the yellow angel?
Yellow devil killed it. He's that good. So in later Mega Man games, they added, like, a green devil. And in Mega Man 9, which they made as, like, an homage to the old games, it was actually made for the Xbox 360, but it was made with 8-bit NES graphics and music.
Yeah.
They have a level where, a Wily level where you fight the yellow and green devil simultaneously. They actually exchange parts with each other. And
you have to blow
up the eye when it moves between the two blobs. Like, they did not pull any stops in that game. They went for, like, full original NES hard.
It's unfortunate that it wasn't the blue and yellow devil, because then they could make the green devil.
The Green Devil's actually a lot easier in the games, though, because it was later games where they gave you things to deal with it better. So, like, the Green Devil was never scary to me. Although in Mega Man X, they took it to an extreme. In X5, there's a Black Devil. And in addition to the name being a doozy, if you really dwell on it, it's absolutely horrible because it... It can fill the entire room, and it can transform into other things besides just like a humanoid between its like blob forms. So, like, it can turn into things that bounce off the walls, and it can turn into like the Wily machines, and they just like they really wanted, like, I know they wanted a callback.
Finally.
Fuck.
Like, I know they
you.
Wanted to... That was really good. That came down to the wire.
He finally got it.
Man really said, fuck you, Spider-Man.
Fuck you, Devil-Man.
Hey, Spider-Man took that guy's electine. But I know they wanted the Black Devil to be a callback to how hard the old games were, but it is, like, it has ended more of my X5 runs than any other part of that entire game, like, by an insane proportion. Although what's cool is its boss theme is the original Black Devil, or the original Yellow Devil theme, but with, like, an organ. Mega Man's one of those series that definitely likes to pay homage to its past.
Oh, right. Oh.
Oh.
Why does that seem like it has freaking ice physics?
It might very well have ice physics.
There's a possibility.
It's just like one underpaid programmer at Capcom who's just sitting there, and he's like, oh. Oh, they think they got me. I'm gonna show them. I'll show all of them. Ice physics when there's a level or a platform one block wide.
Man really said, fuck you, Spider-Man!
Actually, what's funny is Mega Man was not a series they thought would do well. It was one that Capcom did not have a ton of confidence in, because the first one was not really... didn't make any kind of splash outside of Japan. So Mega Man 2 was like one of those studio gambles where they only did it because like people doing it were really passionate about it, and then it turned into this huge sleeper hit.
You gotta love it when the underdog actually does do well.
Yeah, because it doesn't always. Like, a lot of times there's good ideas that get shut down because they just don't perform well because of timing or circumstance, not because the actual quality of the idea was lacking. Because, I don't know if... this is probably obvious, but Mega Man was actually made around the time they failed to get the Astro Boy license.
So, there's an alternate universe where instead of getting a series of Mega Man games, we get a series of Astro Boy games, But then the license expires around Astro Boy 4, and we never get another Mega Man game.
It's crazy to think what might have been when, like, because I think several games have been in because they couldn't get official licenses. Like, several franchises.
I mean, StarCraft being a big example.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah. Because wasn't StarCraft originally going to be a Warhammer game?
Yep, it was supposed to be 40K.
Yeah. Which actually is one of the funniest things, because at one point Blizzard got into a legal issue with GW over between the Zerg and the Tyranids, and GW showed up with evidence that the concept of the Tyranids went back to, like, the very early 80s, way before Blizzard was doing any of it, and Blizzard just, like, had to quietly kind of walk away.
Which is hilarious that GW would try and do that shit to anyone, because, like, looking at a lot of GW stuff, especially old Rogue Trader, come on.
Oh yeah, no, it was, it's, and they, like, there's a lot of, like, Warhammer fans.
There's a company that did the one mech game that had a bunch of stolen copyrighted designs in it.
I don't think so. I think that might have been WizKids, but I could be wrong.
They've never flat out stolen anything, but they've clearly swiped a lot of ideas from other people. Like, a lot of the universe is straight up lifted from Doom.
Yeah.
Time to fight.
Up, freaking... I don't know the name of the game I'm thinking of.
Time to fight Copy Robot.
I usually use the flame weapon against Copy Robot, but really you can use anything. He doesn't have, like, a dedicated weakness. It's just a preference. The fire weapon's useful because it gives you that little shield, so you can kind of push him back from just jumping into you.
Here we go.
Yeah, but then we just keep running into each other.
Yeah, because he can do it too, so yeah, you have to have it at a distance, I guess. It's...
Okay.
I mean, it's not like Mega Man 2 where you can just cheese everything with Metal Blade.
What company made this?
But, yeah, no, Games Workshop is... Oh. Pretty... Like, a lot of their stuff is... Like, they do have some original... There is a fair amount of originality, but, like, their stuff's very derivative, like...
Yeah.
It's obviously inspired by other things, like, very clearly, like, one-to-one things.
There's very little in GW works that are original. The originality comes from how they're remixed. But that's kind of the thing, is when that's their universe... Getting all uppity about copyright violations is,
Okay. The final game it
really
was...
Oh, yeah?
It was the, BattleTech tabletop game from 1984, made by FASA.
Oh, yeah. BattleTech is really bad.
Oh, yeah,
it had a bunch of stolen copyrighted mech designs in it.
You know, it is funny that Games Workshop got so litigious, because, like, there was actually a time, around the time I just absolutely was just loathing them, because not only was the game system just suffering at the time, they actually tried to take legal action to keep people from reselling bits and things on eBay. Like, they were actually trying to, like, take legal action, and eBay actually had to, like, send their lawyers to be like, hey, people can sell their used stuff, idiots. There's nothing you can do about it. But GW has done better in recent years at letting the game designers drive the ship a little bit more. Like, they still have really exploitative pricing models, but they've done a better job at letting the game designers actually make some of the decisions and try to be community-centric in, like, providing updates in a timely manner. And balancing the games. They're still kind of a crap company, but, you know, it happens.
Yeah. You said made it to the...
Very much so. Thankfully.
Maybe they just were, like, so bad that they, like, Gandhi glitched themselves back around into being, like, moderately okay.
Yeah, reverse Gandhi glitch.
I'll take the extra life because I'm likely gonna die. I'm likely gonna die here.
Come on, have some positivity. I'm positively gonna die here.
I like the little eyeballs. Did you know they're called Susies?
They're called what?
Susies.
Yeah, dude.
It's a cute little name for murder eyeballs. That was a well-placed big pet health power-up. Dang. I do think Electbeam gets MVP weapon in this game.
Kit, when do you want to go off and do our thing?
Huh?
Oh, you guys going off to do your own thing?
At some point.
Yeah, we were planning on running off to do some stuff tonight. Our schedules have been kind of rough.
Wow.
Yeah.
You guys enjoy your
We live in different states. The asterisk on stuff is unfortunately somewhat limiting, but. We do what we can.
Yeah.
Well, you guys enjoy your stuff.
Thank you,
Shell.
Yeah, no, we can take off whenever. I'm free for the afternoon. I didn't have a lot of work on my plate to begin with today, so.
That's good.
Yeah. 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 I work on kind of a queue system, so they stack stuff up and I accept what I can with the time frame I've got, and some days they've got a lot and some days they do not. And today was probably the mellowest API test suite I've ever done, like just textbook.
First time.
How does the copy of you have more health than you?
Because Wily's better at AI.
Yeah, and he's better at making Dr. Lydas.
Which is strange that he then needs to steal, essentially, hijack all of Wily's shit. Or Light shit.
Yeah. You see, he doesn't realize that he's better than him, and he just has, like, these self-confidence issues. He feels like he's inadequate, and so he's trying to make up for his own inadequacies.
He needed Light to lose to his own creations. He's like, call me Dr. Wowie one more time. Say it one more time. I dare you.
I fucking dare you.
Dr. Wowie.
Fuck you.
When did you start playing Bomberman?
Bomberman.
Y'all know there was Bomberman anime.
Yeah! Actually, it's decent.
Y'all ever heard of Beat-a-mon?
Nope. I remember that.
That spawned from Bomberman.
What is it?
Yeah. Yeah, it started off as a Bomberman thing and then kind of spawned into its own separate thing.
Dang, they're just trolling your way into victory.
I am the great knower of all.
Nice. He's doing the victory jig.
I legitimately thought I died because he was doing the victory jig.
So, I gotta tell you, one of the most unexpectedly good party games was Bomberman 64. I just remember the multiplayer for that one being so good. I actually miss Bomberman games.
CeeLo, is the formatting stuff supposed to be going around my image?
If you're watching it on Discord, then yes.
Okay.
I could just move it like there.
Yeah, it was kind of distracting.
Sorry.
You don't want to know exactly how many pixels you are and how precisely you're aligned?
Not really. Not really necessary, no.
I was gonna say, I'm doing it in this way so that I could see which... So that I can see how well it streams when we do the live dub of Okami.
Oh, okay.
I see. Alright, Kate, you're gonna get going then.
Okay. If you guys had fun, sorry I was slow getting over here.
Oh, you guys are good.
Have a good time.
Have fun on your day.
Yeah.
Hey, thanks. Will do. Bye.
Bye. Are they gone? Good. I fucking hate them. Okay.
Man, you held it in for a long time.
But no, I do like them. They're good guys.
Them and their stuff.
Them and their things.
Oh, that was close!
A little too close. Zero, you think we can ever talk you into playing a multiplayer game?
Yeah.
I want to if we can find a multiplayer game that my computer can handle.
We might have found one.
Yeah, there's Balloons 6. There's Left 4 Dead 2. I know that any computer can really run that.
If a computer can't run Left 4 Dead 2, can it really run?
Yeah, exactly.
By the way, even in this scene, you can see freaking Dr. Wily's complete obsession with Guts Man.
His slightly unhealthy obsession with Guts Man. I think we might need to interrupt Zero's stream for a second to actually strategize.
Yeah.
Alright, so if I place her there, that holds us for a while. So let's just let that run for a little bit, because we're fine like this for a while. So if we place Glue Monkeys up here top and then the exact same part down here at the bottom, that should help us. And remember to put your hero somewhere, because you have not been doing that.
Well, my hero is stupid expensive, problem.
Yeah.
He's 810 gold.
Dude, that's nothing. See? You got him now. It's fine. Alright.
So what are you two playing?
We're playing Balloons. We keep getting screwed over, so we're actually, like, talking and strategizing now. Okay, so I'm going to put a ninja in the middle. Can you save up for a power? Because if we can put a radio tower in the middle, that'll boost everyone. And make sure when you put down your sniper, you actually put it next to the tower so it gains that boost. Instead of just throwing him off in the corner.
Well, it threw him off in the corner, because he has infinite range anyway.
Yeah, but if he's next to a tower, then he can get boosted fire rate from that, which benefits him greatly.
So who's saving up for the monkey tower, the monkey village?
You know what, it's fine to find you.
Now it's time for a miniature burst rush. That I took damage from that fire that was still there. Dang it.
Put down a ninja so we won't have to worry about there we go. That should take care of Gamma's. And if I can get enough money to upgrade him, he can also pick up a low level without an issue.
Dang it.
This next upgrade's kind of expensive, so I wouldn't mind if you could share some money with me.
Which upgrade?
I'm gonna go to Flash Bombs to then to Sticky Bombs, because Sticky Bombs will insta-kill no labs.
Now I have to wait for him to scroll back.
Okay, I'm not gonna be able to afford the Moab Destroyer, but as long as you invest your money into your sniper, we should be able to make something that can take care of the Moab. If you didn't blow all our money on stupid shit.
Listen, alright? I've got a system.
Buying pointless towers in bad places?
Yes.
I hardly call that a system, my friend. More of a bad financial decision.
I fail to see your point.
Dun. I end up taking so much damage from these bosses, it's... I'm just hoping that I can make it to the... I'm just hoping I can make it to the checkpoint right in front of, frickin' Wily Machine. But the question is whether or not I can actually make it that far.
That is a good question.
Might be the most important question of your career.
Time to fight Wily Machine. Let's do it.
Do it, do it.
Destroy the Wily Machine.
You must destroy the Wily Machine. I keep forgetting these frickin' guys show up. It doesn't matter if I use up the energy or not of weapons because I have the... Because there is a mega heal item at the end of the stage area here.
We had it.
Alright, I need to do the exact same thing again, but this time on round 39. Buy something.
Yeah.
You do know you can wait until later to buy that sniper so you can afford your hero, right?
I can afford my hero in a couple rounds.
Okay.
I just want to go ahead and have him now, so I can start upgrading him as soon as I get the hero.
Alright.
Don't give me none of that bullshit,
I get more experience if you buy him earlier.
Look at me, I'm bully. I've been playing this game longer. I know more about it than you.
You, bro. Anyway, how's Zero's fight for vengeance going?
Doing better.
Is that an exploit I see?
No, that's actually that's actually Iceman's. That's Iceman's weakness. If you're getting close to me, I'm just gonna shoot you in the face. Time to fight the Wily Machine again, this time I have all my lives. At least I know that first thing's weakness.
All right, what do we need right now? Coming up.
We should be able to cover everything but the lab, really. Because the R2 tower should be able to handle leads, Sada can handle camos. Yeah, we just need to be waiting for that Moab. So, I can crack open the Moab. The question is, how do we kill what's inside of it? I think I have an answer, though. That'll work rather nicely for us.
Yeah.
Crack open.
I guess if you could give us a tower to upgrade everything and drop that in the middle, that would be really handy.
Can you drop a tower in the middle of Wily so that I don't have to deal with this nonsense?
Unfortunately, it would just boost your range and attack speed. Wouldn't give you that much of a bonus to your buster.
Game is over!
Nice! See, I knew you could do it.
Nice.
I did not, in fact, know you could do it.
I had no faith in him whatsoever.
Well, I'm happy to prove you both wrong, you bastards.
We're his devils, the other two are his angels.
Mega Man has even ended the evil domination of Dr. Wily and restored the world to peace. However, the never-ending battle continues until all destructive forces are defeated. Fight, Mega Man, for everlasting peace. Staff. Planner, AK. Character designer, Yasukichi. Tompon. NF King. Yep, that is Mega Man 1.
Nice.
Ah!
Oh shit.
It's almost 6 o'clock.
It's almost...
I've been going for a while.
Yeah. But this is the type of game that you could, that anybody could do just like one stream in. We still have, we still have about maybe like 20 minutes before it's 4 o'clock. So, let's take a look at the... Let's take a look at some stuff here.
4 o'clock for you.
Yee. Let's fight Dr. Wily again! No.
This bastard and his time zone differences.
Yeah.
Let's take a look at the database. This actually shows, like, the amount of hit points and attack points that they deal. Mega Man has 28 hit points and hits for, like, 1 damage.
Mega Man kind of sucks.
Big Eye, change key. Wait a minute. Let's see here. Watcher. Gabuol.
Gabagool.
Kamadoma. A robot made to protect crops from pests. Killer Bomb. Like, an industrial robot designed to blow up distant objects. Also known as a missile. Adhering Susie. A barrier robot made to watch over dangerous locations. Crazy Razy. Guard robot, destroy its body and its head will detach and start rampaging. Super Cutter.
This missile is a sort of robot.
Yeah. Super Cutter, made out of fundamentally the same material as Cutman's cutters. Quite hard stuff, but not to engage.
The same material.
Yeah. Screwdriver. Originally a fire-extinguishing robot, it fires lots of shots, so it's best to destroy it before it gets the chance. Sniper Joe. Guard robot, for that reason, it's got a defect... Got an attack-deflecting shield. Its design is based on that of Proto-Man. The small robot clad in flame, its name is Change Key. Isn't that also the name of a Pokémon?
Clefki.
There's the Big Eye. Pickleman.
I'm Pickleman!
An industrial robot created by giving arms and legs to a metal. Footholder, an elevator robot. Originally, its random movement patterns make it quite annoying. Blaster. Fires on an enemy at spot. On any enemy it spots. Bunby Heli, a reconnaissance bot with a built-in camera eye. Pepe, bird-like robot with little rapid fire. It's nothing to be afraid of. Bomb, bomb, bomb.
Did you just?
Something happened in the game, or was that me?
No. Aiden just, like, took up the last spot where I could have placed a tower.
Well, you didn't tell me what tower you were gonna place.
And you just... Could you just sell that ice monkey? It's not very useful.
Mambu, Metal.
Okay, could you have told me you were going to place a super monkey? At any time, do you think it could have been pertinent to tell me that?
What? It tells you that I was going to reserve a spot in there. Sorry.
There's the Yellow Devil. A large robot made of shape memory alloy. Its parts will always come at you in the same pattern, so memorize its pattern and dodge. Copy Robot. A fake Mega Man created by the copy system. CWU-01P. A robot originally created to monitor water quality.
No! Still! Barely anything is...
Wily Machine 1. A robot controlled by Dr. Wily. Its firepower goes up when its shield is destroyed. Dig down this evil windback piece once and for all. Then there's... Cutman, Iceman, Bombman, Fireman, Electman, Gutsman, and Mega Man! Production.
Believe it or not, Zero, this is the game both me and Bully agree is really fun.
The one that has us getting just raging at each other.
The one that has us both being fucking Wings of Redemption at each other.
Alright, we just need to be better with our active skills and we'll be fine.
We just need to get good.
Yes, we need to be better at the game. If we can do that, we'll be fine.
Yeah, these are all pictures of... There's like a old picture and recently designed picture. Bomb Man. Oh, would you look at that? Reference art.
Ah, yes, my favorite reference art, man.
Bomb Man. Reference art for Bomb Man, Cut Man, Dr. Light, Dr. Wily, Electman, Fireman, Gutsman, Iceman, Mega Man, Metal, Roll, and Sniper Joe. There's some and there's also concept art. This is supposed to be Adhering Susie. Concept art for Big Eye. Blaster looked like it was always going to be that. Early concept of Bomb Man is he removes a bomb from his head and uses telepathy to make it explode. And there was also...
Bomb Head Man.
Bomb Man mass production model. I'm a mom, mommy, Holly, and Ruby. Oh, there was a version of Dr. Light that didn't have the beard.
That sounds cursed.
If you take a look, it is cursed.
Yeah, he looks like someone I would not leave my children with.
And Dr. Wily actually looks decent. And Dr. Wily actually
looks... Dr. Wily looked more like Dr. Light than Dr. Light does.
That's not Dr. Light, that's Dr. Light.
This is a version of Electman. Just give him a freaking a ray gun on his head. And then environment concept. This was the idea for Fireman. Basically have his body all freaking covered in fire. Gutsman always looked like Gutsman. Iceman always looked like Iceman. There's fucking tiny...
Alright, you want to save up for the Super Monkey, or do you want me to put it down?
You put down the Super Monkey, I'm gonna put down the Monkey Village.
Alright, and make sure to go for the middle and bottom path. Or, sorry, the top and bottom path. The top path gives us extra fire rate on everything, which is going to be more helpful than being able to detect camos. Because in the long run, I'll just put down something that destroys camouflage.
Oh, this is interesting. There's unused enemy types. Unused enemies. I think, actually, that one might have been used for later, for, like, Mega Man 3. Watcher. Oh... That would have been a nightmare to fight. freaking early concept Wily machine. That I think that's more like a different thing than Wily UFO, Yellow Devil. Here's some promotional art. Yeah. More promotional art. There it is. Look at it. Look at it.
yeah. The American promotional art.
Look at it in all its glory.
God, that was something else.
Energize your entertainment. Action-packed arcade proven favorites. Power 1 megabit memory. Dynamic high resolution graphic. Not graphics. Graphic.
Bingo. Yeah, a one graphic.
Captain Commando Challenge Series. Capcom's unsurpassed quality. 1 million bits of responsive memory. Sharp, brilliantly clear gameplay and graphics. State-of-the-art technology.
Oh, somehow.
Okay. I think we just weren't using active abilities. I forgot to do it the last few times. What about you?
Yeah, take control. Yeah, you are...
I forgot that my guy's active ability could stun shit.
Yeah.
That was me.
Yeah,
that was
both of us.
You are Mega Man, the one remaining savior of the human race. As Mega Man, you must infiltrate, break down, and ultimately destroy the 7 separate robot-like societies dominated by Dr. Wily, scientific genius gone mad. Send Capcom a self-addressed postcard paid envelope.
All right. The what we needed some needed a little bit of anger management lessons.
Yeah.
Eventually, we are going to need to deal with Camo Lead, so we're going to need to put down something that destroys Camo. Probably put a... Yeah, there we go. Deals with that problem.
Okay,
yeah, that's
so,
gonna hold us for a while.
So I'm thinking I might. So I'm thinking I might just end the stream here. We have about 10 minutes left until 10 minutes left. How much more time do you all have?
Gonna stay in a little bit. We're gonna go hang out with Dan later, right?
Yeah.
All right, that's it. So good.
Okay then. So I'm gonna go. I gotta go ahead and. If that's all right, I'm gonna go ahead and end the stream here, because I need to cool off after dealing with Mega Man 1.
Understandable, friend.
Yeah, understandable, my guy.
Happily, Mega Man 2 should be a lot easier and a lot more fun. So next time, depending on the situation, we might be playing Mega Man 2, or something else if I can figure stuff out. I actually do have a lot of multiplayer games. If you ever want to play something, if you want to get a group together to play something like golf with your friends, yeah, I basically have a ton of games that we have from game night.
Sounds like fun.
Sure.
Yeah, but that would be a game where a lot of us would have to be in to play. You know what I mean? But yeah. Thank you all for joining us, and we will be seeing you all next time. Actually, we'll be seeing you all tomorrow, actually. Good night, everyone.
Yep. See you then. Night.
There is something I do want to do, though. For the sake of time and energy and efficiency and all that jazz, I'm just going to go ahead and do this real quick. Before I end the stream.
Ooh, got those mortars up just in time to deal with all those camos. All right, remember your actives. We're probably gonna need it here.
I'm gonna go ahead and do this. Raid.
Good. Let's keep it on slow for a bit until we have this war under control.
I don't think we'll ever fully have this under control.
Yeah, but it's nice to be able to monitor the situation better.
We're going to raid the Summoner's Network.
Oh, we are. I didn't know we had enough people to raid.
Yeah,